Good morning to all of you. Hope you enjoy your Deepavali holidays. So today we shall discuss modern periodic table or extended form of periodic table or long form of periodic table. Mendeleev's periodic table, though simple, convincing, suffered from certain drawbacks. When the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, all these drawbacks आर वेनिश्ड. हमने देखा था कि मेंडेलीव की पीरियोडिक टेबल में कई ड्रॉबैक या दोष थे और उसका कारण था कि जो मेंडेलीव की पीरियोडिक टेबल थी वो किस बेस पर थी. द एलिमेंट्स वर अरेंज इन द इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ देयर एटॉमिक मासेस एंड वी नो दैट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एन एलिमेंट आर डिटरमाइंड बाय एटॉमिक नंबर नॉट मास नंबर. So it was Henry Moseley who showed that the properties of elements are determined by atomic number. So he gave the concept of the atomic number. Atomic number is the number of protons present in the nucleus of an atom. Since an atom is electrically neutral, therefore it has equal number of electrons and protons. So atomic number is also equal to number of electrons. In 9th class we have studied electronic configuration of 20 elements. And in the lesson, metal and non-metals and carbon and its compound, we have seen the formation of ionic bond and covalent bond, and we have seen it in the formation of a chemical bond, whether it is ionic bond or a covalent bond, electrons take part. So it means the chemical properties of elements are determined by number of electrons. Now considering these,
good morning sir.
Morning. We can say that the properties of elements are determined by atomic number. In modern periodic table, the elements have been arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number such that the elements with similar electronic configuration, that is the element with similar valence electron, fall in the same vertical column called group. Since all the elements in a group have same number of valence electrons, so they have identical chemical properties. So in modern periodic table, elements have been arranged in the increasing order of atomic numbers. Sorry. Now we shall describe modern periodic table briefly. In modern periodic table, like Mendeleev's periodic table, there are vertical columns. These vertical columns are called groups, and horizontal rows. These horizontal rows are called periods. You can see in all there are 18 groups. Group number 1 to group number 18. In modern periodic table, the elements of the first group, leaving hydrogen are called alkaline metals. They are called so because when they react with water, they form alkalis, soluble base. The elements of the second group are called alkaline earth metal, and their compounds are found in the crust of the earth. Elements from group 3 to 12 are called transition metals. Most of the elements in this group show variable valency and they form colored ions. Their salt their salts are colored. Elements of the 17 group are called halogens. Halo pertaining to salt, genus produce, that is they produce salt, so they are called halogens. The elements of the 18 group are called noble gases or inert gases. In these elements, last orbit except helium contain 8 electrons. So it has 8 configuration. Elements in the first group, second group, 13 group, 14, 15, 16 and 17. They have only their inner outermost shell incompletely filled. And all their other shells are completely filled. They are called normal representative elements. Remember, elements of first group, second group, these are transition metals, 13, 14, 15, 16 and 17 group. They have only their outermost shell incompletely filled. Inka outermost shell incompletely filled होता है, बाकी अंदर के शेल इनके completely filled होते हैं. इन एलिमेंट्स को नॉर्मल रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एलिमेंट्स कहा जाता है. इन मॉडर्न पीरियोडिक टेबल मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स हैव बीन रफली सेपरेटेड. Metals have been placed on the left hand side and non-metal have been placed on the right hand side. There is a zigzag line which separates metals and non-metals after transition metals. The elements along this zigzag line, namely boron, silicon, germanium, arsenic, tin, lead, they are metalloids. Their properties are intermediate between metal and non-metal. Sunna dhyan se. Modern periodic table mein aapko metals left hand side par milengi, नॉन मेटल राइट हैंड साइड पर मिलेंगे. लेकिन ये सेपरेशन बहुत एग्जैक्ट नहीं है, रफली इनको सेपरेशन किया गया है, सेपरेट किया गया है. 12 ग्रुप के बाद, ट्रांसिशन मेटल के बाद, एक किस क्रॉस लाइन है जो मेटल्स और नॉन मेटल को सेपरेट करती है. इस क्रिस क्रॉस लाइन के अलोंग जो एलिमेंट है, लाइक बोरॉन है, सिलिकॉन है, जर्मेनियम है, आर्सेनिक है, एंटीमनी है, इनको कहा जाता है मेटलॉइड्स. इनकी प्रॉपर्टीज मेटल और नॉन मेटल क्या इंटरमीडिएट होती है, सम ऑफ देयर प्रॉपर्टीज रिजेंबल मेटल्स एंड सम प्रॉपर्टी रिजेंबल नॉन मेटल्स. नाउ देयर आर 7 हॉरिजॉन्टल रोज ऑफ द पीरियड्स 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. फर्स्ट पीरियड हैज 2 एलिमेंट्स हाइड्रोजन एंड हीलियम. सेकेंड एंड थर्ड पीरियड हैज 8 एलिमेंट्स. फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ पीरियड्स हैव 18 एलिमेंट्स. And then we have 6th and 7th periods which contain 32 elements. Now you can see that the main body of the periodic table cannot accommodate more than 18 elements. So how can 6th and 7th period contain 32 elements? So actually 18 elements have been accommodated in the main body of the periodic table, and after lanthanum, at the bottom of the periodic table, there is a group of 14 elements which are called lanthanides. In the same way, in 7th period, after actinium, there is a group of 14 elements which are called actinides. So 18, 14, 32, 32 elements. These elements of the 14 elements are called inner transition metals. That is in your scope of the 10th class. ये आपको नहीं समझना है, बस आपको इतना देखना है कि where inner transition metal have been placed. First group, which contain period, is called very short period. Second and third period, which contain 18 elements, short period. Fourth and fifth, long period. And you can say sixth and seventh period as very long period. So, एक बार और देख लीजिए. मेंडेलीफ की पीरियोडिक टेबल में कई कमियां थी, दोष थे, और उसका बेसिक कारण जो था वो था बेसिस ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन, दैट वाज एटॉमिक मास. क्योंकि एलिमेंट्स की प्रॉपर्टी एटॉमिक मास पर निर्भर नहीं करती है, एटॉमिक प्रॉपर्टी डिपेंड करती है एटॉमिक नंबर पर. तो लेटर ऑन एलिमेंट्स वर अरेंज इन द इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ एटॉमिक नंबर्स, एंड व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स आर अरेंज इन द इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर ऑफ एटॉमिक नंबर्स, एलिमेंट विद सिमिलर प्रॉपर्टीज are repeated after regular interval of time. This is called modern periodic law. So elements in modern periodic table have been arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number, such that the elements having similar electronic configuration fall in the same vertical column. Now, since all the elements in a vertical column or in a group have similar electronic configuration, therefore they have identical chemical properties. Now, when the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, so all the shortcomings that were inflicted to Mendeleev's periodic table vanished altogether. You can see, since the elements have been arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number, the problem of the isotope is solved automatically, because isotopes have different mass number, but they have same atomic number and same identical properties, therefore they can be placed in the same group. Similarly, you can justify the position of hydrogen in modern periodic table, as the elements have been arranged on the basis of their electronic configuration. So all position of the hydrogen can be justified, as it has one electron in its outermost only shell. since elements have been arranged in the increasing order of their atomic numbers, the problem of anode and pairs in the Mendeleev's periodic table is solved automatically. You can see seventeen group iodine tellurium. Atomic number of tellurium is 52. That of iodine is 53. So tellurium has been rightly placed before iodine because its atomic number is 52 and atomic number of iodine is 53. So this anomalous position of some element in the Mendeleev's periodic table was solved in the modern periodic table. That's all today's.